And welcome back to B&J Gangnam Newspaper Dialogue Collection number 1. We will continue with dialogue number 14. Hey, have you ever heard that song called Sweet Dreams by the Eurythmics? Can you say Eurythmics? It's a hard word to say, so try it out. Eurythmics. Good. It's just the name of a band. Person B says, yes, I have heard it before. It has been about 25 years since I have heard it. Look at this. It has been about 25 years since I have heard it. It has been about 25 years since I have heard it. I think the song is great. It goes, sweet dreams are made of these. Do you know that song? I know that song. Yeah, that's how it goes. Wait, did you say it's been 25 years? Wow, you are super old. Ha 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 ha. All right, and number 15. Do your knees still hurt? I am worried about your ability to work efficiently. I'm fine, thank you. To be frank. So, to be frank means to get to the point, to make your point clear. Get to the point. To be frank means to get to the point or to make a point clearly. To be frank. Alright. So, to be frank, different parts of my body hurt every day. Not only my knees, but also my back, my neck, my head, and my feet. Wow, don't you think you should go and see a doctor? Your health is very important, and you shouldn't work in pain. Nope. I look at it this way. My pain lets me know that I am still alive. Let's cheer up. My pain lets me know that I'm still alive. What a positive way to look at pain, to make you realize that you are still alive. And number 16. You know, Tony, we have a huge problem doing our homework. Yeah, I do, Mark. Our school has changed to a paperless homework system. Paperless means without paper. So when you see less attached to a word, it means without, paperless. Shame, shameless, without shame. Can you believe all our homework, even daily quizzes, must be sent via email or downloaded on the school website? Via means by way of. By way of. Via. Some people say via, but you will hear both in English, via or via. It's like A and A. The dog ate my homework won't work as an excuse anymore. This is a very well-known excuse in the United States. It's more or less a cliche, but it's just used a lot as an excuse when a student doesn't have his or her homework. He or she will say, the dog ate my homework. Even though the teacher knows that the student is lying, the dog didn't actually eat the homework. It's just kind of funny. But you can easily use it too. So just repeat after me. The dog ate my homework. Good job. Alright. And number 17. So, what are we going to do? I hate doing homework for all the subjects. All the subjects. All the subjects means math, English, I guess for you, Korean, science. What else? Art, music, so many subjects. Social studies, can't forget social studies. Maybe you should cut your internet off. Maybe you should cut your internet off. To cut your internet off means to stop your internet, to no longer use the internet at home. Are you crazy? Are you crazy? There's a cash reward for being a League of Legends world champion. A cash reward. lots of money for being a champion, a winner, through League of Legends. That could be good for us. I think we're going to be very good students this year. Alright, and number 18. Hey, I saw you today as your head fell on the desk. Not literally, as your head fell on the desk. Why are you so tired? Why are you so tired? So fell on the desk. Your head, as your head fell on the desk. Means. Alright, so as your head fell on the desk means falling asleep at your desk. Ugh. Because you are so tired or exhausted. I am completely exhausted. I'm so tired. Along with taking 4 college level classes. 4 college level classes. I usually go to bed at 3 a.m. and I am awake by 6 a.m. Only 3 hours of sleep a night. Wow. I could not survive on that. That's called burning the candle at both ends. Burning the candle at both ends. The top and the bottom. Which means you're working yourself to death. You're just doing too much. Do you know that your emotional and physical health is in danger? I know, but I was told that if you snooze, you lose. So if you snooze, you lose. It's a great expression, too. We say that a lot in English. It means you risk losing out. Because you are sleeping. You risk losing out on something because you are sleeping. You say that a lot in English. Alright, and number 19. So, I am curious. I am curious means I really want to know. I am curious. I really want to know. What unique costume have you created for this year's Halloween party? Do you know Halloween? Halloween's a popular holiday in the United States where people dress up in costumes and at parties. Children go trick-or-treating, or they go knock on people's doors and they say trick-or-treat, and typically someone will give them candy. So it's about kids getting candy and people dressing up in costumes. It's a lot of fun. And scary, if you like scary things. I will tell you if you describe what you will be wearing. Well, okay. This year I have found a way to transform into Optimus Prime from the movie Transformers 4. Do you know that movie? I haven't seen it, but I know what Transformers are. So transform means to change into. Transform means to change. Wow, that's amazing. I am going to be the sexy and sneaky Catwoman. I will also be wearing pumps. Pumps are high heels. Women's shoes. You know women's shoes that have the heel? They're very sexy. So pumps or high heels. Hey, hey. But I was just kidding about Optimus Prime. Hee hee. Alright, and number 20. Hello. How are you? Where are you going on the KTX today? Hi. I'm going to Seoul on the 7:30 p.m. train. Have we met before? I feel like I know you from somewhere. Would you like to have some coffee at B&J Coffee Shop? Hey, that's the oldest pickup line. And a pickup line is a way to flirt with someone of the opposite sex. Typically, men do it to get women's attention. And the expression, I feel like I know you from somewhere, or the I know you from somewhere, is a way to start a conversation with someone, even though you might not know them, because you want to talk to this person. So it's a very famous pickup line in the United States and the English-speaking world. So until next time, see if you can use a pickup line the next time you're at the train station.